one time I did my intro, and lads, you know the cheapest and only place to get your ultimate team coins. Make sure you head over to ayoha.com, link in the description, and make sure to use the code Gonth for a discount. Yes, 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 yes. If there's been a video that I wanted to do more than probably any other squad builder, it's the one you're gonna be seeing today. We're gonna be watching players pranking each other. Not always serious, not always professional. Sometimes let's take the piss. Let's have fun. Let's enjoy ourselves. Thank you, my brother from another mother. This guy on the screen, he suggested me the team. He is a legend. I love you, bro. Thank you for the suggestion. I ain't even gonna hang around. We're gonna get straight into it, because what you're gonna see today is just probably one of the funniest squad builders you've ever seen on this channel. I think there's only one place to start, and it's with Mauro Icardi. This guy's always in the headline for doing something, but at least he got a little bit of a sense of humor. And if it's your birthday around this guy, if you ever get the chance to play with Icardi, and you come into training, or just come into just anywhere near the ground and it's your birthday, you're getting egged, you're getting flowered, you're getting slapped. Massage. He had a little bit of a tight hamstring going on there. Next thing you know, he's laying here relaxed. Boom, boom, boom. And the way the other dude comes and slaps him on the back of the head as well. Don't kick a brother when he's down, bro. And the flour on top really just takes the piss, because that makes it hard to get out your hair then as well. These guys are savage. And I'm about to include Eric Boye. Could I just clear one thing up? He's the only black Irish dude I've ever seen. He is one of the only, literally. I'm not even being weird. I'm being serious. I don't see many black people with the Irish flag next to their name. I'm just being honest. Boye, I salute you for that. You're a rare breed. But anyway, he's got a sense of humor, which I like. You better run for your life. If Zlatan catches you, you're getting karate kicked to the fucking head. And trust me, Zlatan did catch him. And when he caught him, you're about to see fear. Oh my god, this is just stupid. He's only messing around. And watch the look on Bayi's face.
Oh, what do you mean, fuck off?
Look at his face.
What do you mean, fuck off?
Look at his face. Did you see the look on his face? That was fear. He went. You know when someone's scared, when they grab the fist. They don't try and defend themselves. They don't stand it. They go and try and grab the hand. And we move over, and it's really unfortunate for my brother Coutinho, bro. Great player. So much potential to be one of the best players in the world. But it doesn't stop you from getting pranked. Especially when you're around people like Neymar. The poor lad. And from one prank, we move on to another prank. Some of these are going wrong, some of these are going right. When Marcelo's involved, you know the prank is going to go right. This guy is just a born prankster. He just looks like a prankster.
Hay que valorar el trabajo del equipo porque no es fácil. Hemos trabajado mucho para llegar hasta aquí. Yo soy del Madrid. Hay que ganar como sea.
Just because it's an interview, Casemiro, don't think you ain't gonna get water poured all over your head from your teammates. You're trying to be all professional, you know, you're doing your Real Madrid interviews, you got your posh voice on, your professional voice on, and do you know what? Behind you, comes this little cheeky midget with his big bobbly social bob here, tipping water all over your head. We've moved on up and the pranks continue in sing. Okay. Do you want to know one of the most classic pranks ever? I'll give you an example. Keep watching. Hey! Hey! I got you, didn't I?
Apri un po' la finestra, va. No, no, non accenderai che mi viene mal di testa dopo me. Apri un po'.
Even the legend himself. The prankster himself, Balotelli. You're not safe, bro. No one, nobody is safe in this game of pranks. You can be the prankster or you can get pranked. You can't pick one. It's gonna happen to you either way. And it didn't take Balotelli long to get on the other end, did it? I told you, you can be the prankster or you can get pranked. Balotelli versus the photographer, this one was, back when he played for Man City. This guy was up to all sorts. I don't need to tell you. You probably read the back pages of every newspaper. The funniest thing is he didn't rob the whole camera, he just robbed the lens, knowing that she can't do anything. And you can tell she wasn't catching him. Yo! Yo! Who would have thought? Raheem Sterling, bro! Who would have ever thought? One of the biggest pranksters in this team. He don't stop, he's actually relentless. This guy's ruthless. You're on a plane with Sterling? Oh, good luck. You ain't sleeping. I know for a fact you laughed at that. Do you see how long he held his nose? You like this? And then eventually he started, like, you would think, come on, bro, like, breathe. Yo, it was ruthless, bro. Like, he literally will not let you sleep. He's grabbing your noses, he's slapping you, he's playing with you. You know those annoying little kids? Those annoying little brothers, or those annoying mates when you go camping or something, and they just don't let you sleep. They're doing all sorts, bro. Like, that's exactly what Sterling is. That annoying little brother. But it's hilarious and it's funny to watch. Never, ever, ever sleep on Kylian Mbappe. Like I said, you're either doing the pranks or you're getting pranked. I've seen a lot of videos of Kylian Mbappe thinking he's the prankster, the top boy, the guy who's gonna get all the laughs. But it seems to be Mbappe who's on the receiving end of quite a few jokes.
Donatello! Donatello! Donatello!
Mip mip. Mip mip. Mip mip.
Depuis tes copines t'ont parlé. Non, non, le mélange t'es proposé. Tu m'as dit tu préfères réfléchir, mais réponds maintenant. Plus tard, il sera trop tard. J'ai plus envie. J'ai plus envie de voir ailleurs.
Non, non, non. Donatello! is the way he's just trying to chill. He's just sitting there trying to chill. And he's got cameras in his face. Donatello! Over to the other side, obviously, we got Paul. Paul. The blackest Paul you'll ever meet in your life is Paul Pogba. And possibly the funniest Paul as well.
Ajouter une étoile sur le maillot. Quels sont les mots que vous avez pour décrire ce que vous ressentez?
On est très heureux, voilà, on est. C'est une grande fierté pour nous.
Quelle sorte de fierté, man! God bless Griezmann for trying to keep a straight face that interview. You could see he was dying. The top lip was going. He was dying just to start laughing. And out of nowhere, you just see this Fortnite, this black Fortnite character, just like jumping up. But finally, we're wrapping it up today, lads, and we have got Neymar Jr. Man, I don't think there's been someone who's been more involved in pranks than I've watched today. Like, the amount of clips I've seen, Neymar's involved in a lot of sus stuff when it comes to pranks. This guy seems to just want to piss people off. He has a sixth sense, like, Right, they're like, should we practice on a set piece? Should I practice on a free kick? Yeah, should I practice on my dribbling? No! I want to practice on a new prank that I'm going to do on some poor soul. Unfortunately for Mbappe, yes, he's starring again, and unfortunately he's on the brunt of another classic school prank. But that's gonna wrap it up for today, lads. Please drop a like if you think this is one of the funniest squad builders you have ever seen. I want you to drop a like and let me know. Tell me right now, did you enjoy this? Was this funny? Did you laugh? Have you laughed at one of these clips? One of these clips that is just one like. But lads, I'm gonna go and wash my toenails. How about that? I'll catch you later.